is up, everyone? Welcome to the show. My name is John Moore, and in today's video, I want to talk to you guys a little bit about how to pick the picks you want to pick your banjo with. That's right, we're going to talk about how to pick your banjo picks and how to fit them to your fingers. So, to start right off with, we've got three picks we're going to be using. We've got three fingers we're picking with, and every single one of those has a pick on them. Now, you might go up to the stand, or you're in a music store or whatever, you might be looking on Amazon or some other online store and wonder, well, which type of pick should I get? Should I get plastic? Should I get metal? Should I get carbon fiber? I don't know if they make carbon fiber picks. They probably do. There's someone trying to sell some kind of newfangled material out there to pick with that's going to enhance the tone of your banjo. The truth is, there's not a lot you can do with that. You can change the shape of the pick a little bit, and that'll give you a different sound. But besides that, there's not a big difference in all these materials. So I wouldn't spend a lot of money on getting nice picks. Just get something that fits and get something that is appropriate. So for our thumb pick, we want our thumb pick to be plastic, and we want our finger picks to be metal, and that's just how it's done in bluegrass music. We want metal finger picks and plastic thumb picks. Now for the plastic thumb pick, we want one that, or I prefer one that's more of just this traditional shape. It's just got a single little paddle on the bottom, and it wraps around over the thumb. Now when we put this on, what we want to do is we want to have this flat portion, the portion that's on the bottom, that has the little pick extension, the little extended part from it. We want to put that towards the pad of the thumb, and the bent portion right here that's arced like this, that goes over the thumb. So that way, our flat portion is against the pad of the thumb. All right. For our metal thumb picks, we want them to go on the same way. We want the picking portion to be against the pad of the finger. And same thing here. I see so often people, they get their banjo picks for the first time, they put them on upside down, especially their finger picks, and they treat them like their claws or something like that. And I mean, that's cool and all, but it looks cool and all, but it's not actually functional. So we've got to make sure we get them on right. So we want to make sure that the picking portion is pressed against the pad of the finger. Now, how we go to fit these picks? Well, starting with the plastic pick, we want one that's going to fit about halfway up the thumb to the first joint. Okay, now if we go a little too far forward, the thumb pick's probably not going to want to stay on there. It's going to have a tendency to fly off. And if you have it too far back, it's going to kind of limit your mobility, and it's going to sort of flex every time you bend your thumb. So we want to make sure we get it right there about in the middle of the first joint of your thumb. And that should have you good to go. It should be a tight fit, not a snuggish fit, not a loose fit. It should be tight. Now, a lot of people say you can adjust your banjo picks, your thumb picks in particular. A lot of people say you can adjust your thumb picks by dropping them in boiling water. I've done it before. It kind of works, but what happens is they usually end up breaking. I don't know what it does to the plastic. It does something to the plastic. They end up breaking. So they just don't last. As far as the fit goes, I would recommend you get them fairly snug. And, you know, if they're too tight, just get the next size up. If they're too loose, you know, get the next size down. And just buy them how they should be. Buy them already fitted for you. And get a good, comfortable pick. Because if you try to shrink down one that's too large, what happens is you've got a larger arc here. And when you try pressing that down, you soften it in boiling water and you try pressing it down to shrink it down. Well, it's just going to start spinning and slipping and sliding around your thumb. And, well, that's probably what it was doing in the first place. That's why you're trying to tighten it up. But now it's going to bend more and it's going to break on you. So just get your thumb picked so they fit right to begin with. Get a good, snug fit on your thumb. I wear a medium, okay? Some people, I started out, I thought I wore a large for a long time, and a thumb pick started spinning. After a couple months of using a thumb pick, it would spin around on my thumb. I'd be like, well, these stinking thumb picks, I don't see how anyone can use the darn things. Well, it turned out I was using too big of a thumb pick. If it's doing that to you, if it's trying to spin around, get a smaller thumb pick. The brand I use a Cool thumb pick. That's the brand, is Cool. Dunlop is good. Golden Gate, I couldn't get rid of my Golden Gate picks fast enough. They just broke on me all the time. They just kept breaking on me. So a lot of people swear by them. I don't care much for them personally, but just get a pick. Any of them will work. Okay, just make sure it fits good. That's the important thing. Now, as far as our thumb picks or our finger picks go, like I said, we want to have the little picking portion towards the bottom of the finger. That's very important. That is essential. Once we've done that, then we can start to shape it to our finger so they'll stay on. Now, they'll come out of the box sort of open, and they won't actually hug your fingers. So what we do is we actually take these, and they'll be sort of like in this position right here. They'll be open like this, and they won't really want to stick around anywhere too long. So you take them and you bend them. You just wrap them right around your finger, and be careful not to get any hard bends in them, because these little thin sheet metal picks, they tend to kink a little bit. So you got to be kind of careful and try to keep a round contour in them while you're doing that. And that'll get you a good, comfortable pick. If you get a kink in them, what'll happen is you'll end up with a hot point or a pressure point in your pick if it doesn't make full contact around your finger, and it'll wear a blister on you. So just make sure you get it just shaped pretty close to your finger and it's not pinching down on your finger. That's not what the picks are for. They're not pinching your finger. They're just wrapped around your finger. And we got to want to get it as close to the contour of your finger as possible to prevent blisters. Okay, so we do that for both picks. And then we've got this little picking end out here. Well, that's adjustable as well. And they'll come from the factory pretty well straight out. Now, some people like to take these little picking ends and bend them up so they match the contour of the finger. I personally don't do that, not with these picks at least. I like these to be fairly straightforward. I like my picks to be an extension of my fingers. I like to pick fast, and that allows me to really pick fast. Having those picks straight out gives me a really quick attack on the string. So that allows me to really pick quickly, and that's what these particular picks, these are Ernie Ball picky picks, they're designed for speed. These are fast picks, and they're faster than your standard, your Scruggs style, your regular picks that you'll find most Scruggs pickers are using. So these are the other style of picks. Now I tend to curve these up to match the profile of my finger a little better, and these are just your standard issue Banjo picks. Now, they have a bit of a rounded tip on them. I'll let you see the tips of the other ones in just a minute. But these have a rounded, they're shaped almost like a spade shovel, okay? And, well, they give you a very fat, tubby sound. So if I was to do something like Sally Ann. It's got a very fat, tubby sound to it. They sound great. But in fact, I would say the tone is maybe a little bit better than the Ernie Ball picky picks. But they don't have the clarity that the picky picks do. And the picky picks, rather than being shaped like this, they're shaped more like this. They come up to a point, like that. And so these, they sound something like this. We've got a little more clarity, a little edgier. We call that a brighter sound. So I like these a little better. They're a bit quicker to pick with. So if you really like to burn it up on the banjo, they're good for that, of course. For a beginner banjo player, you're probably not going to be doing too much burning up. But they're good, versatile picks to pick with. And they're fairly forgiving for the angle. I mean, I can pick with these things like this. Change the angle and the sound is pretty consistent. I don't mean to turn this into an advertisement for Ernie Ball picky picks. I just really have used the picks a long time and I really like them. These, on the other hand, they sort of fall out if you don't keep that angle pretty steep. So that's something to keep up with. You'll see a lot of banjo players, they kind of have the wrist like this when they're picking. That's why, it's because they're using those rounded picks and that's how they get their attack angle. So I like these a little bit better. So now that we've got our picks fitted to our hand, the next thing we want to look at is how to place our hand, or how to position our hand on the head and keep it steady. But we'll talk about that in the next video. Anyway, guys, I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, please be sure to leave it a like down below. Subscribe if you'd like to see more videos like this from me. I'll see you in the next one. Later.